Hello, it's Scott Manley here with a video which is essentially a response to a number of comments in the Kerbal Spaceships Are Serious Business video. If you remember, I tried to land a spacecraft similar to this on the moon, and I made some comments about expecting that I had enough delta V. I had 100 meters per second delta V more than my orbital velocity, and yet I ran out with about 100 meters per second left to go. Now, I had a number of theories, but everybody kept saying, hey, it's bloody obvious, you're losing the delta V because you're fighting against the moon's gravity. So what I'm doing here is proving you guys all wrong, right? I'd already actually done the math on paper, just to be sure, but what we're doing here is we're lifting off from the surface of the moon and we're going into orbit. And we have a window there, custom info window. It is actually calculating the gravity losses. That is the amount of delta V lost because I'm fighting against the lunar gravity. I was about to say lunar gravity. No, this is the lunar gravity on the moon, the actual moon. The spacecraft is very similar. I'm using infinite fuel, so it's not quite the same. But I had estimated that I would lose about 50 meters per second. Of course, that meant that I only had a 50 meter per second margin, so the odds of me landing that thing was still hugely remote, but it shouldn't have run out of fuel before it had stopped completely. Anyway, as you can see, between steering losses and gravity losses, we're talking just over 50 meters per second, and this, of course, is just because you can take the physics of the launch and play it in reverse, and it's the same as a landing, right? The same mathematics works in either direction. The hard part is that a launch simulation is essentially the reverse of a suicide burn simulation. So this is just to show you what happened here. Anyway, the reason that I lost the delta V was because I had the four-way reaction control system thrusters, and when those are throttled up, it was running those thrusters to accelerate me, and those were less efficient than the tiny little thruster on the back, so I was losing fuel through those. I was getting thrust from them, but the amount of thrust I was getting was significantly less efficient than the thrust that I was getting from the main engine. Anyway, as I said, a little bit of a clarification there just to show you what was going on, and some numbers to back it up. I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.